Navaneethakrishnan.
Thank you, sir. At the outset, I would thank our honorable Amma for giving me this opportunity to stand before this August gathering. The block money is opposed by each and every individual citizen of our nation, and also there is unanimity among all the political parties that block money must be brought to India at any cost. Now, we the people of India are very poor, no doubt about it. Then there need not be any statistics or data required to prove that fact. There is also unemployment problem, for which also we need not show any data. But the problem is, on one hand, very poor people are living in India. On another hand, the very same Indian people, those who are deposited their ill-gotten wealth in foreign countries. Now, in India, we have adopted the rule of law as our tool to govern ourselves. But our system of governance with regard to tackle the block money is not sufficient, it is not effective. That is why the block money is able to be deposited by the Indian people, those who have violated the Indian laws, and they are keeping their money in foreign banks. Now, thanks to our honorable Supreme Court, the Supreme Court has seized of that matter, and the special committee is also formed and constituted. Now our central government is also giving their reply to the Supreme Court. Now I hope and I expect that we are in the safe hands of the central government. Now in our honorable finance minister and our information technology minister are the leading eminent legal luminaries. They would find out the ways and means how to bring back the block money to India, because I am of the very humble view, subject to correction and approval. The legal system presently available in India is not sufficient, not effective. Of course, we are having the Reserve Bank of India, which is called custodian of Indian economy. It is also not delivering any goods. And also we are having formerly Foreign Exchange Regulation Act. Now we are having Foreign Exchange Management Act and also Money Laundering Act. These acts are not sufficient, and also we must explore the ways and means through international organizations, entities and the diplomatic channels to see that no Indian or Indian legal entity can deposit their ill-gotten wealth in any of the foreign banks. So if there is any money is deposited, they must get the approval from the government of India or the Reserve Bank of India. In such a way, we have to frame the regulations. In future, we have to prevent it, and also to bring back the money already deposited. I again trust that our honorable finance minister and the other ministers, like our honorable information technology minister, will find out the ways and means and frame the suitable regulations to bring back the money. And we are in the safe hands of the central government. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you very much, Miss Maya.